Hey there, welcome back to my channel. We are gonna go thrift shopping today. It's been like my favorite thing to do for the summer because I have summers off and I've been getting really bored, and this just fills my time with, I can spend hours inside the thrift stores just going through everything. So I'm gonna take you along. Finally, this has been a long time coming, and we'll see what we can find. The Goodwill I go to is extremely small. We have other thrift stores in the area, but my favorite place is this particular Goodwill, and I can, like I said, spend hours in there. So we'll go, and then afterwards I will show you my haul of everything I got, and I will see you very soon. Bye. Stuff at Goodwill, like a ton of stuff, a huge bag filled with clothing. Some of it's gonna go in my Poshmark, but a lot of it's just like a back to school type clothing haul for myself because I can no longer like bring myself to spend as much money in like the normal stores when I can just go to this specific Goodwill that's like a really ritzy area and get extremely nice stuff. And I have both cats in front of me, so at any point in the video, you're probably gonna see their little faces. Okay, I'm also going to do a styling type for some of these, not all the items. Again, some of them might not fit. We'll just have to roll with it. I didn't try all of it on. The first thing I got is actually for Anthony, and I'm hoping this is right. I think this is the Pittsburgh Penguins. I asked someone in the store, I'm like, positive that's their logo, but like 90% positive, and no one could help me. So it's just a men's like baseball tee. I think he'll really like that. And that was, I think, like $4.99 ish. And then, oh my god, I'm gonna say and then so much. I got a dress by Tahari in a size 6, which fits perfectly on me. I think I might have even had this on in the fitting room with the camera. But it's just blue, it goes down to my knees. It's classy and I can wear this to work. So I thought that was a good find for myself. I got a Lily Pulitzer dress. This is in a size extra small, which is not gonna fit me. So I'm not gonna put this on, but it's just a really basic cotton dress that you can just wear around casually or even to the pool if you wanted to. I'll probably put that on Poshmark. Dresses were like $6. I got this dress right here. It's by COS, and I'm pretty positive that's like a really expensive line. I'm gonna try to put the original type price in the video so you can kind of see how much it was and how much it probably was for someone else. It's actually pretty cute. I don't know for sure. I think I'm gonna keep this and just wear it to work. I think with like white tennis shoes, this would be really cute. We'll see though. I might end up selling that. I think I'll probably keep it though. Does it fit? It's like a really loose dress. I almost said shirt. A shirt dress. This is by Theory. This is, if I remember correctly, this is a brand in Nordstrom that I never go over to because I looked at it once and it was like $1,000 for like a dress. So we'll see how much this retails for. It's just like a fall jacket. I don't know. It's navy blue. I'm not sure if I'm going to keep it on. I haven't tried it on. It may go on Poshmark or it just may go in my closet. Leopard print is really in right now. Nordstrom anniversary haul, that's all people wanted. I have never heard of this brand. This is by Hyped Unicorn, and it's in a small medium, and it's just a really oversized long, like a varsity type sweater. I thought it was cute. I think this with my liquid latex leggings is gonna be actually really cute, and maybe my white sneakers. I can picture it. This is going to stay in my closet. I think sweaters were $4 and something cents. This guy was on clearance today. All the red tags were half off, so this was like $2.50 or something like that. It's just an American Eagle sweater. And it's really basic, but I thought that would go well for the fall and winter for me. And then this looked really cute on too. I think this was like $4 and something cents. It's just a basic tank top. I think it's from Urban Outfitters. It's by Skyzer Blue, which I'm pretty positive they carry. And it looked really nice and it looked in really good condition. So that's gonna be a work item also. This is by J.Jill. I'm not sure if I'm gonna keep this one for sure yet or not. I might end up giving it to Anthony's mom, but I really like the color. And I feel like I could wear this to work a lot too. It's just a very long cardigan and it was half off, so it's like $2.50. Very, very cute. I got a Lululemon capri workout pants. These are going to go on Poshmark. They are reversible, which I thought was really cute. I like this side though. And they're in really good condition. I believe they're like a size 4. Or size 2. Let me see if I can figure that out. I've had them on and they felt like a little snug on me. I'm thinking they're a 4. I just don't know where. Oh, there it is. Well, this sticker's out of it, so it's gonna be a guessing game, but like it was a little bit tight on me. And I usually wear like 6s or size 4 in a line, so I'm thinking this is just a size 4. That will go on Poshmark. Oh my god. Oliver's inside the bag. You are the reason people get suffocated. This is so cute. I bought this for swimming at the pool. It's just a brand new with tags. I got it for like, I think $3 or something. And it's by Philosophy. It's a pool cover up. It is so freaking adorable. I'm gonna wear this probably today. Will you get out? Are you? This is what I'm working with right now. He won't let me pull anything out of the bag. What are you doing? You're naughty. Then by Athleta, this is a swim cover-up. It has built-in bra cups, which I'm not exactly sure why you need that. That just still doesn't make sense to me. It's brand new with tags. It's the Venice Swim, originally $79. And I'm going to sell this on Poshmark because it's in a size extra small, which probably is gonna be a little small for me. But I saw it on the model. I looked it up online and it looks really cute. So that's gonna go in the sell pile. Then I have a Lululemon tank top. This is really cute. I did not try this on. It might just stay in my workout collection. If it doesn't fit right, I'll put it on Poshmark. But it's just a neon yellow and gray and it has a built-in sports bra. And I think this was like $4. Very good deal, very good condition. I'll see, I'm not sure what I'm gonna do with that yet. Another Lulu, no, just kidding. An Ala Yoga tank top. This I didn't try on either. This was half off, so I got it for a couple dollars. And it has a built-in sports bra, but there's no padding in it, so it's probably, you probably still wanna wear a sports bra underneath of it. The back looks really cute though, I like that. I'll probably end up selling just because I don't love the color pink on me. It makes my red face come out real harsh. So that's gonna go online. I got a, I'm gonna be washing this stuff too because I know you're gonna be like, you got a bra. Yeah, it's a Free People bralette. So I've been wanting one of these and now I have one and it was like $2. Is this the last thing? I feel like I had more than that. This is by Mink Pink. And it's just a long sleeve. I think I had this in the video too when I was in the dressing room. Just a long sleeve work top. So I'm gonna wear that to work. I'm keeping that. Okay, that was everything. I hope you enjoyed this video. I probably won't be going to Goodwill as much now that school starts up. So maybe next summer I'll start doing this again or on the weekends. Also, if any of you are curious, I know some of you know that I'm from the Dayton area. We had a mass shooting recently, which is crazy to think about just being in like your backyard because the El Paso shooting happened. And like that night I was talking to my neighbor about it. He lives underneath of us. He's just an older man who has a concealed carry weapon. And we were talking to him, and he's like, yeah, like, I have this weapon just in case something like this would ever happen here. He's like, it probably wouldn't. And we're just like, well, you never know. And then we went to bed, and the next morning we woke up, and yeah, the whole shooting happened. And it's just crazy to think that, like, it can literally happen anywhere. I remember all day just, like, refreshing until the news would update who the 10 casualties were. Because I know a ton of people that go to the Oregon District, and I myself go to it, so I was nervous the entire day. I luckily did not know anyone that passed away. I know my friends knew some of the people. I feel awful about it. I know this may not be the popular opinion, but like, I really, really feel for the family of the shooter. And not that I don't feel bad for like all the families, I obviously do, but the fact that they lost that child and then also lost another in the process because he ended up killing his sister, I can't imagine what they are going through right now. And I just really hope that people are letting them grieve and like heal through this, because I know the stigma with having like a child that does do some like heinous crime, you don't really get to grieve them, and it's not really fair. And it's not fair that their life is completely public now at this point. And people are going through photos being like, when, like, maybe they should have known, someone should have warned someone. That's not always the case. And I'm sure if they thought their child was going to hurt someone, that's something that would have been told to the authorities ahead of time. It's just one of those crazy incidents. And it just, I don't know, it breaks my heart. So yeah, if you've ever had to deal with anything like that, there is like support for you guys out there. If you're one of the victims' families, or even just like working in a school, freaks me out already, because that's the main place where I feel like a lot of shootings happen, and you always have to do training every year, and it just puts it in your head and it's nonstop. I just wish the world was a nicer and kinder place and safer place to be. And for the most part it is, but then you're gonna have things like this that's gonna just like mess with your brain. So anyways, I'm not sure where I was going with that. I just wanna let you guys know that I am safe. Obviously I'm here. And if you are affected or have been affected by it ever in the past, just know there's people out there that can relate and understand you, and there's also people out there that can help with whatever you may need in the healing process. Anywho, I'm gonna head out. I need to go to the gym because I have been so awful at going to the gym. You guys have no idea. It's been a really bad gym year. I'm gonna say the year. Yes, it's been a bad year, but you have your ups and downs. I'm in a downward spiral right now, but I'm trying to boost myself up, so let's go do that. Love you very much. See you guys soon. Bye.